Hi, I'm Iain Anderson, and in this video, part of a series, I'll be showing you how to create and edit splines, simple shapes, inside the Mocha interface. I'm in Final Cut Pro with this Hong Kong skyline clip on a timeline. I've applied the Continuum 3 strip effect to a clip, and I'm going to use Mocha Mask to isolate the effect. We'll start here at the top of the window, with the Shape tools. You can create spline shapes for tracking and masking using the Rectangle or Ellipse tool, or draw a spline with X-splines or Bezier shapes. We'll come back to this important choice in the next video, but for now, we'll use the X-spline version of these shapes. If I use the Elliptical X-spline tool to create a selection over this area here, notice that it creates a new layer on the left of the window. Now I can drag from corner to corner, and if I want a circle, I can hold Shift. But if I hold Option as I drag, I'll be drawing from the center. I'd like to improve on my original shape, so I'm just going to delete that one with the trash can button and draw another one like so. To move it into position, I'll use the Arrow tool to select all of these points with a quick drag and then just move them over. Mocha is a planar tracker, and we'll look at the pixel patterns inside the spline shape. If you want to zoom in or out, just use plus and minus, and use the hand to move around. Now you can choose what kind of motion you are tracking: translation, scale, rotation, skew, and perspective if you want to. Starting from this position on the timeline, I can track backwards by clicking here, or forwards by clicking here. First, I'll track backwards, then return to the original point and track forwards. Once tracking is complete, all the tracking data will be stored on a layer. Each layer will be tracked individually, so if you want to track another object in your shot, you can use the same tool, if you like, to create another layer and track that separately. And the color of each layer can be changed to make it easier to see what's going on. However, if you want to combine multiple shapes on the same layer to create a more complex shape, you'll want to use the tools with the plus in the icon. If you create a shape with one of these, like I'm doing now, you'll be adding to any existing shapes on that layer, and you'll then be tracking a larger single area with a more complex outline than you could achieve with just a single shape. And that's all we'll need to make this track work. Combining shapes will only take you so far, though. To see how to edit these shapes, and to learn about X-splines and Beziers, come back for the next video. Thanks for watching, and see you soon.